December 27th, 2022. This morning, I woke up 6 o'clock in the morning to see what type of emails I have, any type of cancellations, any updates, or whatever. My first email is congratulating me on my sign up for March 5th marathon in Napa. I guess Rosa has made her decision. So on Friday last week, Rosa and I were talking about our plans, our future plans, our plans for this marathon. And being that she's still in shape for the last marathon, it's only been 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks removed, she still feels that she is not 100% there, but at least she's a lot more in shape now than she was when she first started. So she wanted to take this momentum and do a marathon sooner rather than later, which I am excited for. So I also told her that if we were going to do the Napa, that we'd have to immediately start training in January to prepare for this marathon. So she's made a decision. I haven't even spoken to her yet. I literally just woke up, saw the email, texted her, said, hey, I guess we're running in March. I still haven't received a text back. She's stuck traveling. There was a lot of cancellations, so I'm sure I'm not gonna hear from her anytime soon. But I wanted to make sure that everyone knew that we are running in Napa for our first marathon, March 5th. All right, I'm ready. Let's do this. Another update is for Christmas, I received a gift from Lissy, a rented Peloton bike. So instead of purchasing a bike, I guess we are renting a bike for my Christmas present. And in the meantime, start the cycling training little by little since I don't have a bike at the moment. I will be buying a bike soon. Yeah, I didn't realize how expensive these bikes were. But again, one of the first things that I've been reading on the on reviews on people's first Ironmans is a lot of people went cheap on their bikes, saying they really didn't need an expensive bike, they just needed a bike. And one of the biggest regrets that I see a lot of people talk about is not spending money on a bike. Now, I don't wanna spend $10,000 on a bike. I'm not going that extreme, but the budget that I had budgeted before, I will be increasing that budget to buy a little bit more expensive bike. I'm not one of those people saying I should have bought a better bike. I want to make sure that this ride is as comfortable as possible. I don't want the bike to be a hindrance on me. One of the things that I've learned a long time ago from my friend Chris is do not be cheap on your equipment. And all the backpacking and all the hiking that I've done, I've never been cheap on my equipment. I've always bought quality and expensive material or products, and I've never had any complaints. So I'm not gonna change that. So I will be getting a bike soon, but in the meantime, I will be practicing the cycling training on a Peloton. That comes in on January 6th. It is now December 27th. I won't be receiving that for another week or so. But now things are starting to slowly come together where the training, now all three sports are coming in. I'm still doing my swim training. I will now have to implement running training again, and now I'll have a bike, so I have no excuses to not do cycling training. So now here, although 10 months away, I'm now slowly starting to fine-tune, not my exercise program per se, but I guess the tools for my upcoming race. I'll keep you guys tuned. All right, real quick, I thought I was finished with my video that I just filmed. I was just about to take the phone off, and I received a text message, and I'm gonna read it exactly the way it came in. I had texted Rosa this morning, and I said, "Good morning, Rosa. I see that we are running in Napa." Question mark. That was this morning at 8 o'clock this morning. And I just got a text back from her saying, "Ha ha. Omar, yes we are. I watched Iron Man week 7 last night just before going to bed and then registered." That excites me. I just wanted to share that with you guys. Yeah, it's happening.
All right, I just finished my body spec scan. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you just a quick little video of their advertisement describing the scan that I just took. So go ahead and check that out. So that way you have a better understanding of what I'm talking about when I refer to the scan in this video and in the future.
With BodySpec, you can visualize and learn exactly what's working in your everyday diet and exercise routine to improve your health. BodySpec is a mobile DEXA scan service that gives you a comprehensive look at your personal health data. We take a detailed snapshot of your body broken down region by region into fat, muscle, and bone. The scan is easy. No change of clothes or any awkward process. Just lay down for a quick 10 minutes on the scanner and come out with a highly accurate report detailing over 50 personalized data points in your body.
All right, so now that you checked out the video, I just took my scan. The beauty is I've been doing the scan for several years now, so they have my account on file. So the great thing about the scan is that I have a history of all my scans. I do scan myself about once to twice a year. I'd like to do it more, but with the membership, they give you free credits. And what I usually do is I like to give my credits to my clients so that they can get their scan. So it makes it easier for me as a trainer to have their info as opposed to me doing, you know, the measuring myself. So it's much, much easier with the scan. With this year, or this with this goal of mine, I'm definitely gonna be doing it once a month. So that way I have my results documented and it holds me accountable. Not only do these videos hold me accountable, but the scans hold me accountable as well. Two other details that I love the scan for. One of the numbers that they give me is they have a measurement of my each individual arm. So the scan will tell me how much body fat I have and how much muscle mass I have on each limb. So what I like to do is to compare my left arm and my right arm to see what the difference is on the size. So for example, on my arm scan, my arms are exactly the same muscle mass wise, fat mass wise on both sides. So to me, that's balance. Normally on a dominant hand side, let's say I'm right-handed, normally it would be very common for my right hand to be bigger than my left because I just do more things with my right. My left is just there to stabilize where my right is the working. So more working my arm does, the bigger it gets. So the good news is that they're both even. Now my legs. Now my right leg is bigger than my left leg. Again, common, but I know it's not because of what I just detailed. The real issue is I've had surgery on both knees. I've had meniscus surgery on my left and my right. On my right knee, I had my meniscus sutured stitches. And then on my left knee, I had my meniscus scraped. So they just removed it. So two different types of recoveries. The scrape is much, much easier, much faster because the broken or the torn part is no longer there. So the recovery is just much easier and faster. On the sutured, my right, the recovery was longer because it needed to heal and all that good stuff. I'm not saying one is better than the other. I just had an opportunity to have one on each knee. So I've learned a lot and I've had a lot of advice to a lot of people who were going to or are going to have meniscus surgery. I have a perspective on both. So on that sense, I love it. But my left knee, I injured it in jiu-jitsu and it's injured only if I bend the knee fully. So you know how some people kind of sit on their knees, sit on the knees or on their butt is touching the heels. I wish I can do that, but I can't. My left side limits me. So although it doesn't limit me on my stability, it doesn't limit me on my workouts, it doesn't limit me on anything, there's still a little bit of compensation where my left is 1 pound lighter than my right. So that's a huge, huge imbalance. So that's something I'm definitely gonna be focusing for this race is that every time that I scan, I'm gonna check to see the imbalances of my left leg and my right leg. All right, so that aside, the biggest thing for now is I'm 220 pounds. I fluctuate to 220 to 225, and that weight for me is comfortable. I love this weight, and let me tell you why. This weight is based on just jiu-jitsu. That is it. 220 pounds for me in jiu-jitsu, I'm big enough, but not too big where I can't move, where I don't feel mobile, I don't feel flexible. 220 is a perfect weight in that sense. 220 is also, it's heavy enough where I don't feel like I'm bullied by the bigger athletes, the 250s and above. At 200, they just throw me around at that doesn't make me feel comfortable. So 220, perfect. Ain't nobody throwing me around. But for the Ironman, there's no way that I need to carry all this additional weight for no reason. So I need to lose 20 to 25 pounds. Now, in order for me to do that, I need to monitor how much intake or how much energy I'm consuming. So now for the last week, I've been monitoring my food. I downloaded an app called LifeSum, and I've been using that app for the last 10 years on and off. Every time that I need to re-jumpstart my nutrition, I always download it. I do it for the 6 months or so, and then I'm back on it. So now I'm back on it because I need to lose this weight for the race. So for the first week or 2 weeks, I've already done it for a week. I'll do for another week or so. I need to get a baseline. Once I have a baseline, I'll have an understanding of how much I'm consuming. Now, the macronutrients, I'm not focusing on that yet. The reason being is I need to wean off my caloric intake that I'm currently taking, and I'm gonna need to take some food out to create a deficit. So I need to experiment with my nutrition, so the macronutrients are not gonna be my main focus as of yet. Now, everyone has different ways of doing things. That is just my way of doing it. I've always done calories first, macronutrients later. So now I'm averaging, it's just premature. I need another week, but I'm averaging so far about 3,200 calories per day. The scan said that I have my resting metabolic rate at 2,000 calories. Now, my resting metabolic rate is just the amount of calories that I expend at total rest. So if I didn't do anything all day, I just laid there, it would be 2,000 calories expended based on my fat mass and my muscle mass. So with those numbers, my resting energy expenditure on average is about 2,000 calories per day. Now that is numbers that I took or that I'm taking with my Apple Watch. So I'll show you in the Apple Health what my average is, caloric burn at rest. Now my caloric burn activity-wise or active is approximately 1,200. So with those numbers give me this, how much I'm currently moving around. But I can't be this running Ironman. So I have an understanding of what is maintenance. Now I need to experiment on how much I'm gonna consume and being an endurance athlete at the same time. So that is my plan on how I'm gonna ease into losing 20, 25 pounds for the Ironman race. Woo! All right, so wish me luck. That's how I'm gonna slowly get into my new nutritional habits. We'll see how it goes. See you guys next week, week 10.